This quick tour of the Brother 1034D Serger will get you familiar with where everything is. So as we go through the videos and I say something or point to something, you have an idea of where and what we're doing. So we have it threaded, and I do like to put, when I'm starting off or having students take the class for the first time, I love having them use the colors that match their tension guides. That way, when they serge and they have a little sample and they're done, they can reference, oh yeah, the blue thread does this, and they'll know what that particular area is referencing. So I always love to color code my samples. So as you're going through these videos, you might like to follow along by putting the different colors of thread on. The tensions here, I do like that you have four is a number that if they get turned and they're supposed to be all back to a normal number, you can just reset them to that particular number. Easy, easy. The other thing is that people sometimes have trouble is getting the thread all the way deep into the tension disc. And these have a little quick release that allows the tension disc to open, and you can just push that over and then they kind of close up. That actually is quite helpful there. Your presser foot lifting up and down, you'll see I actually don't use that very much. I just put my fabric right up to the foot and it takes it in. So the less that you can actually lift and lower the presser foot, the better, because if you accidentally leave it up and serge, well, it just doesn't work out very well. You also have a free arm to this particular serger. To pull it off, you do need to use a little pressure, lift up just a little bit, and it'll slide out. That way, if you have a sleeve or even a pant leg that you're serging, you can easily put that around and slide it back on as well. Just make sure it's nice and flush once you push it back in. Your next dial is over here on the side. You got quite a few options here, is that you can adjust the cutting width. So you'll see this part here moving kind of closer to the needles and further away. We'll describe that not as stitch width, but cutting width. How much fabric is actually being cut off based on how thick your fabric is. So there's sometimes where I have really thick fabric, I'll set that to a smaller number. And it is highlighted at 5, so that is a nice return to number if you don't know what the setting is. R is for rolled hem. We usually cut a little bit more off for a more dainty hem. So that's why the R is there. We also have stitch length. Stitch length will determine how long the stitches are and how fast the fabric is fed through. So if I have really thick fabric, I'm going to set my stitch length longer, just like you do on your sewing machine. And if it's a lighter weight fabric, I'll bring the stitches a little bit closer. So 3 or 2.5 is a nice normal setting. Again, R for rolled hem, usually we bring those stitches much closer together. The last one out towards the end here is differential feed. And again, I'll show you how this works. But what it does is allows the feed dogs, which are two separate sets of feed dogs underneath, you can have one pull more or less than the one behind it. So if the fabric's coming out wavy, we're going to play with the differential feed. And here's how I remember it. If people are new to this, if you turn it and it gets worse, it will go the other way. So if you don't have to use this a lot, but boy, when you need it, and it's right here for you. We'll also use differential feed with the gathering foot. So there is a great use for that that helps pull the fabric in even further. But if you also have some fabric that's puckering underneath and it's not supposed to pucker, we can adjust it the opposite direction and it will assist in making both layers come out perfectly smooth. So again, one's going to make it worse, one's going to make it better. Can't remember which way, just give it a try. The other one is a release for lowering your knife. This is one that I'm going to talk about that we don't use a lot. Leave your knife engaged as much as possible. It's not something I do take out because it's what I watch when I'm actually serging. So without it there, I have nothing to watch. So I'm going to recommend that you leave that engaged as, like I said, all the time, unless you're following something and they truly don't want you to cut something off. But you know what? If I don't want something cut off, I run my fabric right next to the knife. But then I have a guide. I have something to follow. So that's why you will find me always leaving the knife engaged. That gives you a quick overview of the serger. Now, this is a great little catcher for all the threads. It just slides underneath. You're probably going to see me use the serger more without this because I'm always in and out as I show you different things throughout these videos. So it just slides in there, but tell you the truth, we're going to set it off to the side for right now.